Now, when the history repeats again, the only question is that, will we win this time? We all believe that this revolution will be the end of dictatorship. So, what is our game plan to win this time? We are pushing back against the military coup in various ways. First, civil disobedience movements. The civil disobedience movement, also called CDM, began as an online campaign and has expanded into the strongest pro-democracy movement. More than 90% of civil servants, like medical and healthcare workers, railway station staffs, bankers, lawyers, teachers, students, and engineers, they all refuse to serve the military gender by not going to work.
Without staffs, hospitals, banks, schools, and municipal departments cannot function. And without the obedience of people, the genders cannot run a government system properly.
CDM is the living proof that the gender lacks control over the land and the people. CDM also includes not paying any tax, including food, electricity, water, etc. So the military gender has no money to pay for the salaries. For the non-CDM staffs, well, our CDM staff, they get enormous support from people, and the National Unity Government is planning to pay salary to honorable CDM staffs. Then, the military started ramping up the pressure on those associated with the CDM, using forceful tactics. Workers associated with CDM have been thrown out of public housing, railway staff were forced to leave their apartments, and arbitrary arrest warrants were issued. Although they are wallowing in the mess of struggle, losing their houses, financial difficulties, and even struggling to eat every day, they do not quit CDM, which make the military genders modify. Now, the Myanmar Civil Disobedience Movement has been nominated for the 2022 Nobel Peace Prize. Come on, our CDM staff deserve the Nobel Peace Prize. Protesting on the street. So, we protest and speak out with our voices so that the military genders hear us and the whole world hear us too. We protest under various titles such as 5-2 Revolution, Military Alliance, or May the 2nd Global Revolution, etc. The point is that we protest every day. Protesting against the military gender is not as simple as you might have thought, because we all are risking our lives whenever we go out to protest. Live rounds, snipers, tear gas bombs, and stun gun raids. All sorts of weapons are used to hurt and murder people who are merely exercising their right to freedom of expression.
According to statistics,
795 people have been murdered by the military gender already. There will be more, sadly. But we still go out to protest. Although protesters on a smaller scale than those in previous days, we still have the dawn protests, morning protests, and evening protests. They are all happening despite the crackdown of the military. It is difficult to gather hundreds and thousands of people in one place, so we protest around our neighborhoods. No matter if it rains or it's sunny, we are still protesting and demanding the military to step down and release all the detainees. Besides, protesting on streets, We are also very active with the online campaign that we also call Symbolic Strikes. We are nothing without our ideas. Our creativity, bravery, and courage are the future of Myanmar. Finding creative ways to protest this military coup is what we always do at the moment, so that the international community is constantly aware of our situation. So these are some of the things we do. Banging pots and night projects. It is a tradition to drive away evil spirits from our lovely country. Don't forget, it is our daily duty at 8 p.m. Three-fingered salute. The gesture adopted from the Hunger Games series, expressing solidarity and resistance to the military coup. Roadblocking strike. We try all the crazy ideas to hinder the movements of the military forces. Setting car engine stops in the middle of the streets, and then crowds of people crossing the streets back and forth, or picking rice grain on the streets. We are all crazy ideas, but we do it anyway. And then we also do silent strike, marching shoe strike, green day strike, flash strike, Easter egg strike. In this modern age, we use all the modern creative ways to protest. This is the era of the Generation Z. In this video, we've presented what Myanmar people are doing to fight against the military junta. But what is our National Unity Government is doing at this moment? Who is the legitimate government of Myanmar, both in law and on the ground? The tension between the two players is heating up every day. And we will talk about this more in our next video.